Sikri, Vaiko.
Sir, Pakistan.
Your name was third in the list. I'm calling out your mouth and you have 3 minutes only. Only 3 minutes. Please speak. Your speech will go on the record.
I would request the Honorable Home Minister. Just now you stated that Vaiko will be permitted to speak. But the Deputy Chairman says only 3 minutes. Opposition parties, they have not spoken. 1 minute, sir.
There are nine speakers. Let me clear.
Why should you give me time? That don't allow me. Allow me to speak.
I'll give you 1 minute.
It's a very important
I'll
matter.
Give you 1 minute more.
And you are telling me 3 minutes.
I will give you 1 minute more.
Shouting text press for 3 hours. Shouting text press for 3 hours. You are allowing me 3 minutes. What
don't,
is justice?
Don't waste your time. I
what is
you are a senior man,
what
senior parliamentarian. Please speak.
Is it your matter to talk in 3 minutes?
I am going at per record and the norms of the house.
Sir.
I'll give 1 minute
I ask
more.
The government. Sir, the great parliamentarian H.V. Kamath, when the Article 356 was discussed, he stated that this day is a day of shame and sorrow. Today is a day of sorrow because we have not kept our promise when the Pakistani troops, Pakhtuns, entered the terrain of Kashmir. King Hari Singh sent emissary to Jawaharlal Nehru. And Pound Patron also was there. Jawaharlal Nehru accepted the instrument of accession was signed. Sheikh Abdullah, the great leader of the Muslim population of that valley, supported. Let us go with India. But on one condition, the individuality and originality of the state of Jammu and Kashmir could not be compromised. Therefore, there should be a plebiscite. This was promised by none other than the late lamented Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Plebiscite should be done. He wrote a letter to the Prime Minister of UK that plebiscite will be held. In 1948, 1949, 1950, 1952, till 1958. And Sheikh Abdullah, what was the reward? He was put behind the bars in Tamil Nadu Kodaikanal prison. Then what happened? 1964, M.C. Chagla, the ambassador of India in the United Nations, he stated, already elections have taken place. That is the plebiscite. A fraud was committed by the Congress party. I have got all the respect for Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's discovery of India at glimpses of world history. No parallel book in history. I bow my respect to Jawaharlal Nehru. But the promise was not kept about the plebiscite. You viewed India plebiscite in Gurgaon state. Here, what has happened further? You said the individuality will be protected by the Article 370 and 35A. Now, sir, today, Mr. Nazir Ahmed Nawai did tear the constitution here. He did tear the constitution here. I won't object even the constitution is burnt by him. I won't object. Please listen, because I have burnt the constitution of India in 1986 on Hindi imposition and I was imprisoned. When Mr. Chidambaram asked, you wrote the verses in a piece of paper, you are cowards, you did not burn the constitution. On this same house I said, Mr. Chidambaram, would you yield for a unit? I burnt the constitution of India. I filed a separate affidavit in the court saying that I have burnt the constitution of India. I was prepared to, even if I am expelled, Mr. Chidambaram kept quiet. Now I tell you, all these years, you killed democracy, Congress party, every time. When Farooq Abdullah was taking tea in a cup of tea in the morning, he came to know his government was dismissed. I told my friend Farooq Abdullah, you forgot the advice given by your great dad, Sheikh Abdullah Ji, when you took me to meet Sheikh Abdullah in 1980. Sheikh Abdullah told me, my young friend from Tamil Nadu, don't forget, there is no place in the dictionary of Indian political history, either for friendship or for gratitude in Congress party. These are the words of my Sheikh Abdullah. Sir, now what has happened? You have not badly bifurcated. nomenclature itself has been changed. We have, when the Pondicherry is claiming for statehood, you are equating Pondicherry with union territory of Jammu and Kashmir and union territory of Ladakh. Sir, when the Kargil war took place, Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the prime minister of this country. My bosom friend, beloved friend, George Fernandes was the defense minister. Our Tamil boys sacrificed their lives in Kargil, shedding their blood. We gave our lives for the protection of Kashmir. We gave our lives. But sir, what has happened now, sir? Taliban, one side. Al-Qaeda, one side. Now, you are playing into their hands. This government, I am telling you, Shakespeare, please listen me. Sir, please listen if you are really interested in this issue. Sir,
record, yes.
Shakespeare stated in Macbeth, even 1,000 perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand of Lady Macbeth. So, that has happened today. That has happened today. You have state removed all the powers. The statehood, a separate state, separate constituent assembly, separate constitution, separate flag, a prime minister, all these things were assured by the Congress party, not by Johnson, not by the BJP. It is you who promised. You did break the promise, toppling the government frequently. You played with the sentiments of the people of Kashmir. Sir, what is bothering me for the last few days, when the army was completely, army personnel 2 lakh times were deployed there, really I am, my heart is burning, because it should not become a Kosovo. Kashmir should not become a Kosovo. Kashmir should not become a East Timor. Kashmir should not become a South Sudan. That may happen. Kashmir will become a Sudan, South Sudan. Kashmir will become a Kosovo. Please listen. If you are really interested in democracy, listen my voice. You may differ. My view, it will be internationalized by the United Nations. There are countries which are opposed to us, India. There are enemies to India. Then they will use this card. United Nations and Human Rights Council will definitely interfere, and Trump is playing his cards very carefully. He's a clever jackal. Donald Trump is a clever jackal. He is playing his cards very carefully. Now what is China? One side. Pakistan, other side. Afghanistan, this side. Taliban, one side. Al-Qaeda, one side. Now they will say, it has become a Kosovo. It has become a South Sudan. It has become a East Timor. Therefore, we have to interfere. This will come. The interference is going to come from United Nations. And this, you have made a powder keg. Now Jammu Kashmir has been made a powder keg. I am worried. I am really worried about the future. Sir, this bill, particularly this bill today, I shed my tears of blood. I am not going to live for more than 10 or 15 years. But even after my demise, my grandchildren will not forget this day. This bill should be thrown out. It should be rejected, lock, stock and barrel. But the main culprit is the Congress party. I am opposing this bill. I am terribly opposing this bill. You are playing with the sentiments. Here that my colleague, my member, Naqvi Ahmed Nawai, you may throw him out by your using your marshals. Mr. Deputy Chairman, you can throw him out through your marshals, but lakhs and lakhs of youths, of Muslim youths of Kashmir, will you throw out? Could you throw out? Could you throw them out? No, no, no. Fire is burning in the hearts and minds of the Kashmiri people. The powder keg, one spark is enough. That spark is the bill. I oppose the bill. This is a day of same murder of democracy. Today, the democracy has been murdered, has been murdered, has been murdered. Murder.
Thank you, Mr. Vaiko.